Happy New Year to everyone. Good to see everybody here today. It's getting a little messy outside, so we're going to have an accelerated sermon and out the door. I don't know that. I'll throw that out there.
It works for me.
Couple announcements. We will have a prayer meeting, prayer service this Sunday. This Thursday. And a board meeting on the 16th?
17th.
Right here. I didn't have to say it. Everything's right there in print. Any other announcements? Thank you.
Please join me this morning in our opening hymn. Please stand, number 478. We'll sing all the verses.
Thank you.
My Savior's love and great is His faithfulness. You know, so we're going to hold on to that. And through this whole year, God is faithful no matter what in our lives. And also, His love for us never ends, never stops. And so hold on to that from this very first Sunday all the way to the 52nd Sunday and beyond. Great is Thy faithfulness. All right. It's good to see all of you here today. Right up front here, and we're not trying to embarrass anybody. I won't even look at it. Judy's family is right there somewhere. All right? And so, if you see somebody, looks like Judy's family, they're right over here somewhere. All right? Anyway, glad to have them. Glad to have all of you. And if there's anyone here, you know, we prayed this earlier about some of our church family. Hopefully, those who aren't here today that, you know, that they're okay. God is with them. I already put some names down here. The Snyder family are traveling to Florida so they can leave us. And I kept telling them, I don't know if that's God's will, but oh well. And also, I want to pray for Allie, Bo, this is Bo, raise your hand. Bo's daughter called me and asked me to pray for her aunt, Jenna. who is having some medical problems and that, and also dealing with her spiritual. So hopefully that's going well also, so we're glad for that. And remember that. And also remember Renee and her family still, and Mike, your family, and all those who have lost loved ones, you know, in the last year. That, so we're still remembering them. Any other prayer requests? Oh, go ahead, Pam.
Pray for Phil. Both of his knees have gone completely out, and he can't walk. He's on crutches. And so he's got an appointment with a knee surgeon Wednesday to determine whether to win and whether to do both knees or one at a time.
So he'll be joining Buddy.
Yeah.
Maybe Buddy will let him use his walker. Yeah. Hey, do you remember when you used to get up and there'd be no sounds or anything? No, you know, no hurts or anything, you just jump up? Yeah. There was a time. And by the way, when you get to heaven, it'd be that way again. Same thing, you know. Don't have to worry about that. There's no rehab in heaven. Isn't that pretty cool? No rehab. There we go. All right. Anyone else? Oh, wow. Yeah, the Collierville Christian Church is closed today due to their pastor and his wife having some virus, so they want to be safe there for that. I'm sure there's a couple others I've read that would be going to be closed today because of that.
So,
don't forget the military. Yeah, the old military. Do it. Your dad? Oh, your dad, yeah. Your, and, wait, Walter? What?
Raleigh.
See, somewhere family's there over here somewhere. Yeah, Raleigh. They're dead. Did you all know that this is like Judy's year anniversary, right, Judy? Something like that? She's been with us for a year. Man, what a blessing, you know? Man, in spite of everything that happened in 2021, we got this. The world got the virus, we got this. Man, what a deal. You know, you can't beat it. Can't beat it. You know, it's kind of like in the Bible where God says this. I will take all your sins upon me, and I will give you all my righteousness. Man, what a deal. Well, they got all the virus. We got you. Same thing. What a deal. All right. Hey, I don't know if you noticed this. Where's Winston? Winston brought this up. I did not do this on purpose, but notice how my pen matches even my color pattern there. Thank you for that, Winston, for bringing that up. Yeah, you know, don't think I did this on purpose. You know, I asked an 8-year-old what tie should I wear, and they tell me what to wear. So, you know, anybody, any other prayer requests? Anybody? All right, you know, what we do now is we'll take a few moments if you have any unspoken or other, any kind of requests, and then I will pray and we'll finish that up. Father God, we come to you now here in 2022. I'll get it straight here. But anyway, here we are, Lord, in this new year. But like we just sang the song, Lord, and how thankful we are for that and how precious it means to us. Great is thy faithfulness. Even if we mess up today, at tomorrow morning, the song says, and also Lamentation says that, your mercies are new every day for us and forever. We thank you for God who loves us. And even in the midst of our unfaithfulness and our unbelief, he is faithful to us, never to be unfaithful to us. We thank you for that. Lord, we have prayer requests here. We pray for Allie's Aunt Jenna, who's struggling with some physical issues and also some spiritual issues, Lord, and assurance of her eternity. We ask, Lord, you help her with that. Help her to have the assurance of knowing that she knows for sure, that she can know for sure. And all of us, we pray, Lord, that we all know for sure, we know for sure. We pray for the Snyders as they're traveling, Lord, giving them traveling mercies. We pray for Phil, Lord, Pam's husband, issues with his knees, Lord. We pray that all good things will come out of that, and the doctor will be able to help him out with that. Also with Buddy, his knee rehab. Thank you for that. Lord, we pray for Murray and Betty and Kathleen, those who are struggling with a cold or whatever it may be, and others who may be out today. Lord, we pray for them. Charles Wiggins and Dorothy, also Sue Brent, Judy Mitchell, all those who are struggling with physical issues, Lord, we give them to you. We pray for Judy's dad. Lord, be with him, Lord. And we just pray for peace in his life, Lord, and also how much God loves him. We pray he knows that. And just for our military and for our country itself, Lord, as we go into this new year, Lord, help us, Lord, this year, as Americans, as America, as our church, as individuals, to continue to trust in God. Have him to be the forefront in our life, Lord. Help us to look to God for the things in our life. Lord, we thank you as you gave us this prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Oh,
read this morning from Matthew 7, 26 and 27. But everyone who hears these sayings of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rains descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on the house, and it failed. Great was its failure. Its fall was few. The writer of this devotional said that there was a great actor that was going to a theater. And right before he was to go on stage to talk, the manager of the theater came up to him and said, "Look, we've got a fire that's in one of the wings. It's under control, more or less, but we need everybody to exit the building. And you being such a great speaker, would you go before them and tell everybody to make their way to the exits?" So he walked out on the stage, and everybody started applauding, and he said, "Woo-hoo!" And he said, hold on, everybody, quiet. "We have an emergency, ladies and gentlemen. We're asking everybody to orderly make your way to the exits." Boy, the crowd erupted. "Oh my, listen to him talk. What a great speaker he is. Oh, he's great. Please, listen to me. There is an emergency. We have a fire in one of the windows. Please make your way to an exit now, while there's still time." Oh, you would have thought he done offered Mom $1 million. They all started applauding. Bravo! Oh my, what a great speaker he is. And I'm glad I bought tickets to this. He had tears streaming in his face. Please, listen to me. This is not part of the show. This is a true emergency. Make your way to the doors, please. Now the writer of this is, you know, it sounds silly, doesn't it? Nowadays, if somebody screams fire, everybody's going to take off running. But he said, don't we do that in church a lot of times? We think, "Whoa, didn't the preacher sound good today?
Amen."
Boy, I tell you what, I'm glad I was there today to hear him talk. But they don't heed to the words or to the truth that he's talking. As soon as they get to the front door, it's all forgotten. It's all for naught. Jesus said in the verse I read, the man that doesn't heed to the truth, listens to the truth, and follows it, builds his house on sand. Where's your house? Is it on the rock? Or is it on sand? I know there's some Sundays I leave before I get home. No offense, preacher. I've forgotten what we talked about. I done got distracted. I got a shaky house some days. It's a new year.
Yeah.
It's a good day to start. I hope you got a good word today. There you go. It's all I've asked. So if we come to the table, regardless of your denominational affiliation, you're welcome here at our Lord's table. He prepared this table for us a long time ago. Is your house on sand? Or is your house on rock? I need to talk to him some days about it. That's what I plan on doing. Let's pray. Most loving, gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you again for the opportunity we have to gather here once again around your holy communion table to remember you. Father, we ask you to bless the bread, that as we partake, may the Holy Spirit within each of us be fed, be strengthened, and be refreshed, that as we go about our week,
each of us be strong enough to stand up and have our house on the rock. It's in your Son's holy name that we pray. Amen. He broke and said, "This is my body which has been given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Again, most precious and heavenly Father, we're reminded of the love and the sacrifice you made for us on that cross and the blood that you spilled, which is represented here in this cup. Let's help each of us here today.
Thank you.
Resolutions of any kind, but you ever take inventory about, you know, some things about your life, spiritually? I thought I'd write some of mine down. How much time I spent in God's Word? There's one. You know, I tell people, hey, if you read one verse a day, and you look at that verse and try to apply it to your life and study it, I'm sure God's pleased. But how much do I spend in God's Word? Or my prayer life. We're talking about that in Sunday school today. Sometimes my prayer life is just, Lord, I need you right now. And I mean, and I'm so glad when I see God working right now. Is some of those. Also, what about our service time for God or our witnessing time for God? How did I do in that? I look at that. Was Sunday school and worship time a real priority in my life? And then I look at what changes are necessary to me to take it to the next level as far as my spiritual life is concerned. Or maybe I look at it like this. What did I see God do this year for me, through me, and also around me? I look at that in my life and see what God has done there and how I'm doing about that. Here's another. What truly is, when it comes to God, what is really my passion for God? All right? And so these are things that I look at in my life. And as wonderful as this can be, you know, you're reading your word, you're praying, you're studying, coming to church. Oh, here's one. I'm sure Bo's not like this. My giving. You know, my offerings and my giving, those things. Which is important to God, by the way. I'm not trying to make fun of it. It truly is important to God. And it should be to us. And all these is wonderful. But think about this, that God would say, as wonderful as this is, what he has waiting for us this year. What awaits us, you know, these next months to come. And so we're going to be looking at that. I always look forward to this sermon in a way, or this time, because of that. Because I love where I'm going here with this. In Isaiah chapter 43. And in Isaiah 43, this whole chapter, basically you can look at it as God's resolutions to Israel, but we apply it to our lives. And I can even say God's new year. New meaning not new as far as something, not old, but something new quality-wise. So God's quality year for us this year. And so I'm going to use the New Living Translation off my phone, which that's okay nowadays, isn't it? Sometimes now preachers, remember in the old days we used to say, turn your Bibles to, now you can say, can you scroll down, you know, to it, or whatever you do. But I'm going to use the New Living Translation. And what it is this, God is telling Israel, and he's telling us, we apply this to us, and he gives them three resolutions. And the first one is that, what we sang about already, God's faithfulness. He says, I will continue to be with you. So no matter what happens this year, how bad last year looked the year before, no matter what, God's promise is this, I will continue to be with you. So as we came, yesterday's January 1st, you know, I did not have my black eyed peas, by the way. I chose something else. But anyway, I did not wash clothes yesterday. Anybody heard about that one? That's another one. You're not supposed to wash clothes. Oh, you, right? And no taking out ashes, right? I did none of that. And I did not watch football. And so all that stuff. But anyway, where was I going with that? Okay. Sound back here? Okay. But no matter what we face this year, starting yesterday, all the way up to the last day, December 31st, God's New Year's resolution to us, or his quality year resolution, is this. I will continue to be with you.
Amen.
Man, and you know, that is so powerful. No matter what awaits us in these days coming ahead, God is already there. I don't know about tomorrow, but I know who holds tomorrow. And great is his faithfulness for that. And he says, I will continue to be with you. Then he says, not only will that, he goes on to tell Israel, and tell us as a church, not only will I do that, but he has called us out. He has called us out from this world, out from whatever, for a purpose. And think about this in your life. So many of us miss this. How many of us really know that God has a plan for our life? Everybody here in this church today, God has a plan for your life. And he's working through that by continuing to be with you. He's calling you out, separating you, whatever it takes to see that plan in your life. And there is no greater feeling, no greater blessing, no greater life than when you're right in the middle of God's plan for your life. And I can tell you without a doubt, without any kind of shadow of a doubt, this is right where I'm supposed to be. And I am so happy right now in my life. And I'm seriously, I want you folks to know this. This is God's plan for my life. I knew it when I prayed for 3 days, asked God, what do you want me to do? And this is where it is. And so God has called me out. He's called you out. There's a plan for each of our lives. And the cool part is finding that plan. And living that plan that God has for your life. So he says, I will continue to be with you. And I have called you out. And then we get to the third resolution that God has made for us. And it comes down to verse 18. And he says this. Here's what happens to the children of Israel, and it happens to us sometimes. We think God is going to do the same thing all the time. That he's going to work in our life the same way. Things are going to be the same way. Whatever it happens, we think it's going to be the same way. And he used the illustration, Israel, that he pulled Israel out of Egypt, and he opened the Red Sea for them, and he made way for them to escape, and he killed the Egyptians. And every time the Egyptians and the Israelites thought God was going to do the same kind of plans. If you study the life of David, when he was in battle, each time he'd go to battle, God gave him a new plan. And I remember a couple of verses there where David would say, well, God's going to do it the same way. Everybody get ready. And God stopped and says, no, I have a different plan. And I'm not always going to do it the same way. I'm going to do things different in your life. It's not always going to be the same. And so he sees that with Israel, and they go, well, God, we know we're expecting you to do the same thing. Sometimes we think as we go into the new year, God's going to do the same thing all year. But he says, stop. And I want to read from the New Living Translation because I like the way they put it. Verse 18. But forget all that. That's the way it starts. But forget all that. What you've seen me do before in your life is what God is saying. What you've seen me do in your church before, forget all that. It's nothing compared to what I'm going to do. That's what God says here. Everything that you've seen God do here at Bethany, everything he's done in your life, forget all that. It's nothing compared to what he has planned for you. Think about that. That's exciting, isn't it? Man, I don't know what he's got planned for me, but God says everything he's done for you in the past is nothing compared to what he's going to do with you this year. So, pardon me, the cough, but he must have some great plans for us here. What? Aren't you excited to think about this? So you get in the Word of God and you start reading. Man, I'm going to find out what it is God has for me. What's he called me out to do? What is it that awaits me in 2022 that God has for me? And the cool part is when he starts revealing it to you. And he goes, so forget all that other stuff. It's nothing compared to what I have for you. Recently, in a recent article, this is what bothered most Christians in that and hindered people when they heard this from God. Well, wait a minute, God. I'm too old. It's too late for me. And the response from God is, I'm still writing the chapters of your life. The book's not over with you. It's never too late for you and I, for God to do what he's wanting to do with us this year. He says, forget all that other stuff. I have all this planned for you. A new thing, he says here. For I'm about to do something new. This new means in quality, new in focus. Something he has never done before in your life. Did you ever take a trip somewhere where you've never been before? How excited you get prior to it, the anticipation, you know, and the traveling and all that. And you get there and you see things you've never seen before. For me, it was the Smoky Mountains. I was born north of the Smoky Mountains, Kentucky. That's where God's from, by the way. Most of you, you'll find that out one day. But anyway, in Kentucky, we didn't have Smoky Mountains. But when I first went there, you know, I was excited about going to Gatlinburg and that kind of area, and just the beauty of it. I always tell Robin, if we ever move, let's move to East Tennessee. I think that's the prettiest place in the world. To me, but the anticipation of us going there, and this is what he's saying. God said, in this year, I have something planned for you, something new in quality, something new in your focus, something you've never done or seen before. And I have no idea what that is for your life or mine, but I know God said, I've got something for you, and whatever it may be. Man, that's exciting. Looking forward to it. You know, sometime during this year, as I seek God's will for my life, my family's life, God's going to reveal this to me. As you do it, it's never too late. Never too late. Did you know God didn't call Moses until he was 80? Wow. What about Abraham and Sarah? 90, 100, you know? I know we're getting close there, some of us, but you know what? God, it's never too late for God to use you and show you something that you've never done before, whatever that may be. What would be interesting is if we write these notes down, and I may do this and put this in my notes. Somebody on December 31st, tell me what it was that you've never done before or seen before, and God showed you this year coming. And it's coming. He goes this, I'm about to do something new, something you've never done before or seen before. And this is his promise to you, resolution to you and I and this church is a new thing that we've never seen before. And I love this part. This is my favorite part about it. When he says this, see, I've already begun. Isn't that interesting? Not only is God promising you he's going to do this for us, not only is he says it's something you've never done before, he goes, it's already begun. The children of Israel, and also throughout the Bible, God always goes before them. And he's there when we get there. So what he's saying in 2022, throughout the year, I've got something new for you that you've never done before or whatever, and it's already begun. And when you get there, I'm going to be there to show you this is it. This is what I was telling you about on January 2nd. Folks, I don't know about you, but somebody should be sitting there thinking, man, this is pretty exciting. I wonder where it is. You know, like I was watching my granddaughter on Christmas morning, you know, those packages that were under there, her excitement, you know. That was pretty funny about 5 minutes after. But there was some excitement going on there, a little, you know, anxiety. And, what could be in there, you know what I mean? And as she opened up that present, think about that. 2022, as you open up the present that God is giving you, going to give you throughout this year, whatever it is, he's already begun doing that. I think that's so amazing. When I just read that, I just stop for a minute. You've already begun it. The years, this is only January 2nd, and it says it's already begun. I'm going to walk into it. You're going to walk into it. Your family's going to walk into it. Whatever God has. That plan for you in this year, it's already begun. And we're going to walk into it. And he's going to be right there throughout this whole time saying, here it is. Walk this way. And here it is. As he starts revealing it to us. And he says here that it's already begun. Then he says here, not only is it already begun, he says, and I will make a pathway through the wilderness. I will create rivers in a dark, dark wasteland. So he's saying, I'm making a way for you in 2022. And the rivers here he's talking about, the water, is the Holy Spirit will reveal this to you. The Holy Spirit will be with you, and he will reveal this to you as you're going through, and he will be with you. So he makes a way for us. He uses the Holy Spirit, and he says, in doing so, by the end of this year, if you read these verses, he says, and you will glorify my name because of what I'm doing for you and what you see, this new thing I'm going to do for you, through you, and in you, and around you. So as we come to the end of this year, a year from now, we'll see that God made a way for us using the Holy Spirit, and we will praise God, thanking him for what he did for us throughout the year. Now, yes, there was a lot of things in 2021 that was terrifying. There were some things that was horrible, a virus and things like that. But we're here. He saw you through all that. You're here. God already began the work last year to get you through that and see you through that. And he saw things you've never seen before. I never thought I could walk into a bank with a mask on and want money and they'd be glad to give it to me. And I'd be in trouble. I mean, I walked in there with a mask on and asked for some of my money, and they were glad. No one asked any, no one said, why are you wearing a mask? Those kind of things. I saw things I'd never seen before. And God was right there with it. And at the end of the year, we praise God for seeing us through it, for taking care of us, no matter what happens. And so he's saying here, I made a way for you. I'll supply the Holy Spirit, and also not only that, we will praise God for this. Then he ends it up with this. He goes, see, I've already begun. I will make a pathway for that, and we will praise God. But I like this term right here, and this is for all of us. He says this, do you not see it? I've already begun it. I made this way for you. And now he says this, do you not see it? And we only see it through our spiritual eyes. We see it through God's eyes and as he reveals it to us. There's a story in the Bible where Elijah's there and his servant goes out and he sees this huge army out there. And they're up on this hill and he sees this army and he's scared. And he runs in and he tells Elijah, goes, there's the enemies out there. There's so many of them. And Elijah says, but there's more of us than there is of them. And he looks at him and he goes, what? He goes, Father, open his eyes so he can see what you have for him. And he goes, and he tells him, go back out there now. And when he goes back out, behind all the soldiers is all these angels. And so he says, you see, there's more of us than there are of them. Well, God is saying this, I have something planned for you as a church, as individuals. I've made the way for you. It's already begun. I'm going to show you something you've never seen before or done before. Do you see it? Meaning, are we looking for those opportunities? Are we looking for whatever he has for us in serving and in being there for others and being used by God? Do we see it? If you want God to do some things in your life and around your life, you need to be willing to let God use you, and you need to be willing to see it. Put on your spiritual glasses. Sometimes we need a spiritual eye test. And he's saying, when you see it, what God is doing for you, step in and see what God, and continue with what God's doing. I love this scripture here. He's just saying, you know, forget all these things in the past, and forget all that. I'm going to do something great in your life. It's never too late. You need to see this, what I'm doing in your life. So as we go, here's our prayer all year. Starting today, is each day as you go, see what God is doing for you that day as he's working his plan in your life this year. See where he's heading and taking you this day and this year. And like the captain of that ship, no matter what's happened, we're going to continue on. We're going to continue on. So our prayer for Bethany Christian Church this year is we're going to keep our eyes open for God, see what he's got for us as a church, as church members, and we're going to keep on going. And I pray that for your family, pray that for you as individuals. God's got a new thing planned for you, and it's nothing that you see going around you, nothing compared to God. Praying for you. Let's all find it. At the end of the year, we're going to say this. Hey, what did God do for you this year? Remember I started off, this year I'm going to do fill in the blank at the end of next year, at the end of this year. Father, we come now. Help us, Lord, to truly see that you have a plan for our lives. You have a plan for this church. Your plan is that you're going to do a new thing for us. New in quality, new in focus, new in things we've never seen before. Lord, but you ask, do we see it? By seeing means we need to look for it. Look for what God has for us. Apply it to our lives. Look for the opportunities. Look for all the things you want that you have for us, Lord. Help us to step into that, what you will have us to do, what you want for us this year. Use us in a powerful way. Lord, thank you for this new year. And what you have planned for us, we know it's nothing that we can ever compare it to, that it's things we've never seen or done before, and it's all waiting there for us. Help us, Lord, to take it and grab onto it. We thank you, Lord, for this year, even as it's just now starting, we thank you for this whole year. Whatever comes our way, like the song says, we will keep our eyes on Jesus. Focus on him. Everything else grows dim, keep our eyes on him. Lord, help us as a church and as individuals in 2022 to look for the new thing God has for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Stand and join in our closing hymn, number 484, the old red cross. Let's sing. How many verses? 1, 2, and 4.
Consider what God has for us, to trust him in all these things, no matter what happens. And in the midst of all things, praise his name, give him the glory, no matter what comes our way. For James tells us, even in the midst of trials, consider it all joy, because it works in our faith. Help us, Lord, as we go this year, throughout this year, trust in Jesus, put our faith in him, and let him show us the new things he has for our life and our church. In Jesus' name, amen.